Dr. Ramo, just last week there was an untimely death of one of our Supreme Court judges, Judge Franchini. What happened in that situation?
Well, we don't know exactly what happened to Judge Franchini, but we do know that every year there are 300,000 people who die suddenly. What happened to the judge is he was giving a lecture, he collapsed, and CPR was begun, and the usual situation is that the rescue squad comes and you wait for them to come, and they use a device called a defibrillator to bring the patient back. I also had another friend who was playing tennis and had a cardiac arrest. He was resuscitated after the same set of circumstances. He was very lucky. Only about 3% of people will survive a cardiac arrest out of the hospital if we have to wait for the rescue squad to come.
I was not aware of that. I thought that by administering CPR, at least you were on your way to survival.
Well, Marissa, there are three things. Let's say I dropped over from a cardiac arrest right now. There are three things that you need to know. Number one is you need to call 911. Number two is you need to begin CPR right away, but unfortunately CPR only provides a little bit of blood, not enough to keep you sustained for a long period of time. The third thing that has to happen is there has to be defibrillation. The heart has to be shocked back into its normal rhythm. And that's where this thing comes in, Marissa.
Right.
This is actually one that I have in my house, which is truly a waste of money. But it's not a waste of money if you have it in a major building. And one of the things that I discovered when I sort of got after this is that a lot of places, for example, the law school didn't have one. I'm sure many university buildings don't have one. Many buildings in town don't have one. Offices don't have them. What needs to happen is that people need to, if you work in a large building, these will save lives. It dramatically changes the calculus. If you have a cardiac arrest out of the hospital and one of these is used, there is about a 30% chance of surviving. In a casino, if this happens to you, you have an 85% chance of surviving. So I'm encouraging everyone to call the Heart Association, get one of these in their building, train people to use them. Mm-hmm. They're very easy. Sixth graders can use them. Studies have shown they're effective. But we can't tolerate what's going on now where we wait for the rescue, even though we have fabulous rescue, for something to be done.
Okay, well, sounds like you're very passionate about it, and maybe we'll get something going here. Thank you,
Absolutely.
Dr. Ramo.
Absolutely. Thank you.